So the topic for today is network testing and monitoring. The presentation has been divided into two parts. The first part is about network testing and the second is about network monitoring. The figure in the image is of our network tester. There is a remote and the master device which is connected to check the connections in the network. Now a network tester is basically a cable tester, that is the cables connected to the various devices in the network are tested for their conductivity. So it is an electronic device used to verify electrical connections or other wired assembly. It is usually used to verify that all the connections exist and there are no unintended. Now intended connections are the ones that are already present in the network, and those are tested to be functioning properly, and that the information is passed from one end of the connection to the other end. Now unintended connections are the ones that are either short in between or they are connected in the wrong place. So if the intended connection is missing, it is said to be open. That means the connection is not complete. Another unintended connection exists, it is said to be short, that is it's short, like it is short with another connection and the functionality doesn't happen properly. Then if the connection goes to a wrong place, it is said to be miswired. Then we see the parts of the network tester. The image in the slide shows that. So there's a main tester unit, remote tester unit, and there are terminators and ports for the RJ45 and RJ12 depending on the connector that you use. So a network connector mainly consists of five main parts, that is a source of electric current for which is used to provide the electric current and check if the connection is complete, switching or scanning arrangement for monitoring the testing process, then a microcontroller to control the process, display to check the results, and a voltage indicator to check the voltage. So testing is done in two phases or two parts. One is for open circuits, open connections, and other is for short connections. Short connections include unintended connections and the miswired ones. So that testing of a connection is done there are two types of testing a connection. One is a continuity test and the other one is a resistance test. In continuity test, the current is passed in the connection, and if the current is good in throughout the connection, then the test is a pass, or else it's a failed test. And the resistance test is basically done by passing a current through the connection and checking the voltage of the connection, and with the voltage or current relationship we can obtain the resistance and check if the resistance is of the expected value or not. Now for short circuit, the short circuit test is of two types, low voltage and high voltage. So the connection, it is basically the connection or the network is observed when the voltage provided is low and the voltage provided is high, and how it works and the behavior of the connection is recorded and analyzed accordingly, and the test results are obtained. So here in the low voltage connection, the two conductors that are connected, the current in between them is measured, and if there is like this test is basically to test the isolation of the connection, the network. So the low voltage and high voltage is for testing the isolation actually. So low voltage conductors is testing for isolation, and high voltage testing determines if the isolation is proper. That is, if you apply high voltage and the insulation is not proper, it is weak, then the insulation will have to break down and the connections will be short. Then the second part of the presentation is network monitoring. So the network monitoring is a system that constantly analyzes or monitors the network for failing components, and it will send a notification to the administrator in the form of email, SMS or other kinds of alarm for in case of any trouble. So the network monitoring devices, the network monitoring devices have the main purpose of collecting data for the network management devices. So in a way they are a part of network management. So the main purpose of network monitoring is to collect information of all the parts of the network so that the network can be managed and it can be analyzed and be controlled with the use of the information that is collected by the process of network monitoring. So the goals of network monitoring are basically for performance monitoring, fault monitoring and account monitoring. These are the three types of monitoring that we do. First one is performance monitoring, which deals with the performance of the network, that is performance issues. The performance of the network is that the network is functioning properly and without any errors. So there are three important issues in performance monitoring. By performance monitoring we can plan future network expansions, like if a network is needed, if a subsequent sub model is needed to be added to the network, we can use this type of monitoring to analyze how the network would behave if it is expanded and is it appropriate to do that. Then the time of frame of a performance monitoring must be long enough so that a network behavior model can be established, that is the network can be fully analyzed for its behavior. And the third one is choosing what to measure, because there are numerous parts of a network and in some scenarios only a part of the network needs to be analyzed or monitored. So we need to know what to test and what not to. So list of items that are to be measured in a network are called indicators, as they indicate various attributes of the network. So examples of the network connection indicators are given: current availability, node availability, blocking factor and response time. The next type is the fault monitoring, which deals with mainly the errors in the system or the network. So in this type of monitoring also there are two main issues. The first one is there are various layers in a network. So if a problem occurs, it can be at a single layer or multiple layers of the network. So it is important to know which layer has a problem, if it's a single layer or if the layer is connected to another one. So that's a multiple layer problem. So that needs to be analyzed, and that the future for fault modeling can be used in that scenario. And fault modeling requires normal characteristics of a network to an extended period of time. So there are always after some point of time some errors are always going to be present in the network. The network cannot be functioning smoothly all the time. So but it does not mean the network has persistent problems, like due to some errors, like if the error is minute or not that relevant, or it doesn't affect the normal functioning of the network. So that does not mean that fault needs to be rectified then and there. So there are some errors that do not affect the functionality of the network and the other ones affect. So the fault monitoring can segregate those errors, and we can monitor, make the monitoring process more effective and efficient. Third one is account monitoring, which is which mainly deals with how the user is using the network, like how many devices are used in the network and how often are they used, when are they used. So if it's a commercial network, so we can use it for analyzation of the usage of the network by the user, and accordingly he can be billed for his usage, and even his future usage can be predicted according to the behavior of his current usage. So that these goals, these are the advantages that can be achieved by account monitoring. So I guess this is about monitoring, and the previous part was testing. I hope you all understood. Thank you.